God with the person. Amen. So everything I done loose to God for what he showed me, I'm on trust. Amen.
Right.
And so I thank God today, man. I pass it to everybody.
Right.
Amen. Don't you fret yourself no more. Just put the person in God's hand.
Yes.
Trust God. Don't trust the person.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, y'all. But today I learned my lesson.
Yes.
I'm going to put you in God's hand.
Yes.
And I'm going to trust God with you. And God will show me what's in you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I trust God. Amen.
Amen.
All day I got to do not deny what God showed me.
Amen.
Amen. That's all. But I'm trusting. Amen.
Amen.
Now I'm going to pass that over to y'all so that less pressure off of you.
Yes.
Amen. I just thank God for today. Amen. Father, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus. God, we can do all things through Christ who strengthened us. And Lord, we thank you for the strength today. Lord, I thank you for the saints of God, Lord God, that hear today, to hear the voice of you. And Father, as we begin to hear your voice, Lord God, let us not harden our heart, but receive what the Lord has to say. Because you are the keeper of our soul. And Lord, I thank you for what you're doing for Life Abundant Ministry. Lord, I thank you. You gave me my answer yesterday. And I thank you for the answer. And Lord God, I trust you. And oh God, yes, you said, let not my heart be troubled, nor let it be afraid. And Father, I thank you today that I loose the supernatural of your anointing in each and every one of our hearts today. That we walk according to your will and your will only. And Lord, I thank you for you the living life abundant to the fullness of your glory. And you teaching us to trust you in everything. And Father, I thank you for the trust and the truth is in you, in your righteousness, in your power, and in your glory. And Lord, yes, you are going to deliver us. You're going to give us a high hand. And I thank you for the high hand today. I left my God, I thank you.
Thank you.
My God, yes, Satan, and I speak.
Yes.
Oh God, I thank you for you being Lord of Lords, the King of Kings.
Yes.
And Lord, I'll be careful, Lord God, to give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, let's give him a hand. I just thank God for him being God. Amen.
Amen.
And I thank you today. Amen. Because of who he is, I'm going to give him the glory.
Amen.
You know, sometimes we don't give God nothing when things ain't going our way. But who he is, I'm going to give him the praise.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I don't care what circumstance I'm in, I'm going to give him the praise.
Yes.
Amen. I've learned to stand still and just know that he's God.
Amen.
Amen. So today, amen, because of who he is, I'm still going to give him the glory.
Yes.
Just because I can't pay that bill tomorrow, he's still God.
Yes.
Amen. Come on, y'all. So we lose hope when things don't go our way and don't seem like it's going the way I think it ought to go. But he's still God. Amen. He's still God. I was listening to TDA this morning. Amen. He said a lot of times things need to fall off of you before you can go into your promised land. And I thank God today how things are falling off. Come on, y'all. Let it fall off. I used to wonder why things had happened, but it's falling off. Amen. And so receive the falling. Woo, my God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. For my falling off. Amen. Somebody, hallelujah. I'm tired of going around this same thing.
Amen.
Amen. I need to learn how to stand up and be the woman God say I am. Amen. Because I got a purpose. Amen.
Amen.
And I received my purpose yesterday. Amen.
Amen.
And I received it.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Because of who? My God, you ain't got to stand up. Just meditate on this word. Thank you, Jesus.
Every counsel you want, because
take that CD, amen, because we forget who God is when we're going through things.
Amen.
And the topic they function in the midst of. So you got to know how to function even in the midst of what you're going through. And we don't know how to function. When things happen to me, sometimes I get all out of whack, dropping things, get upset, get mad, get discouraged. And some people even quit coming to church. They just quit everything. They lose the focus of life. And this is what the enemy do to us. He wants to get us out of what? Unfunction. If we can unfunction, then we can think. But when you got to learn how to go through function and still think.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. But we don't know how to work the two. Amen. So today, I'm going to show you in the Word how God is saying, through the midst of everything, you got to learn how to function.
Amen.
Really do.
Amen.
People don't know how to function. They find other things to take over that what they can't stand to go through. We find ourselves, we find drugs or alcohol, or we begin to be bitter, we begin to hate other people, think they done something to you, but you've done it to yourself and you don't know how to function. And we begin to pick up other habits. And the habit is not of God.
Amen.
He's the one that created you. So why don't you go to the one that created? Because he knows you better than the alcohol.
Amen.
He knows you better than another woman, a man. He knows you. Amen. Jeremiah 29 says he knows.
Yes.
So I'm saying today, so I'm going to show you in the Word how Jesus gave three patterns, amen, about how the disciple couldn't function in the midst of Jesus not being there. And see, that's where we are. We can't function. We can't function. And Jesus said, if I ain't there, you can't function. So we call on everybody else. We talk to everybody else, but we never talk to the one can calm the function in us.
Amen.
Amen. My God, come on now, this is good now. I don't care how to hear it.
Amen.
Because I'm ready to function in the midst of my mess. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm tired of getting upset and finding other things to try to please me.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I ain't pleased at all. I think that's why you get fat rolls on you and find that you didn't take a chip. Get you a bowl of ice cream.
Amen.
Give me a big bottle of popcorn, the big bowl of popcorn, say, hey, I'm going to watch this movie. You eat more popcorn, you're watching the movie.
Amen.
Come on, y'all. Because we can't function.
Yes.
We find other things to try to keep me. Amen. Woo, my God. Thank you, Jesus. All right, let's turn to Matthew. The 14th chapter, amen. And we're gonna start at verse 22. And I'm gonna show 22 to 33. I'm gonna give you a sister here.
Ebony.
On this side. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I need to know how to function.
Amen.
Yeah. Help me to function. Your kids get on your nerves.
Amen.
And can't what?
Function. That's right. Amen.
You know, everything seems like me. But like God, I'm doing good this morning. I feel pretty good. Here comes somebody to mess up my disturbing. So then I can't function. Amen. So we're going to turn to John 14. And verse 22 down, Matthew 14 to 22 to 33. Amen. All right, let's get started. Let me get my function back. Get
yes, sir.
Amen. Right. Okay. Lock the door.
Amen.
All right, here we go.
And straightway, Jesus constrained the disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitudes away.
Now Jesus done sent the disciples what? Away. Amen. They ain't around Jesus. He done. See, sometimes Jesus send you away. He'll send you ahead of him. Okay, look what happened. Why he did the multitudes, send the multitudes away. Look what happened.
And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary.
Stop right there. Now the ship was where?
In the midst of the sea.
In the midst. The ship was in the midst of the sea. So Jesus let you get in the midst of your frustration. Amen. He'll let you get in the midst of it. So when you're in the midst of it, that means you are all out of whack. You begin to lose it. You begin to lose it. He'll let you get all the way in the midst of it. You can't see nobody but the waves, the problem. You don't see him. So he lets you get in the midst, in the middle of it, Michelle. Some folks will put you in the middle of something and then go what? Get you on function. All focus. You have a goal. Here comes Sarah Lee. My intention is to get you off. So you got to know what my intent is towards you so you can keep your focus. So Jesus let you get in the midst of it. You can't function when you're in the midst of something. You can't function when you're in the midst of something. In the midst of mess. So Jesus let him got in the middle of the sea through the bad part of the torment and the waves. So yeah, some of y'all are right in the midst of your dysfunction.
Amen.
That you can't even function. Amen. All right, let's see what happened.
And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea.
Now look, he waited 4 hours before he went to him. So the wave had got up. Tossing it. Wave got hot. So he didn't come to what? The 4 hours. So Jesus don't come to us when we first asked him because he wants us to see where we dysfunction in. Come on. He can come right then, but he don't come till you get in the midst of your dysfunction so you can see where you dysfunction at. People know how to mess your butt. Mm-hmm. If you want to get next to me, you watch me long enough, won't you?
Amen.
Come on, people have watched you long enough to know how to get you off.
Amen.
So Jesus waited 4 hours before he came to him. And we think Jesus ain't there, but he's there all the time. But he wants you to see where you dysfunction at so you can function. If you know I got an angry problem, come on. And I'm trying to control this thing because it just keeps getting me in trouble. Mm-hmm. If you want to get me out the picture, what you going to do to me first? Come on. You going to make me what? Make me mad so I become what? Dysfunction. So what I do, I'll do something that I regret. I end up either in jail or you are losing, hurt somebody. So people know how to get you out the way because you don't know how to
function.
Amen.
This is good, y'all receive. You will keep your goal where you need to go when you find out when somebody dysfunction you. Now I know who dysfunction me. I know my tongue to the T-I-T. I know him. If I need to get all function, hey, come.
Amen.
See, you got to know what dysfunction you. We don't pay no attention to it. Because it's so normal in the world to keep people what? Dysfunction. This is good. If you receive, you going to, you. So it was the fourth hour. All right, come on, D.
And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a spirit." And they cried out for fear.
Okay, let me show you what they dispatched more fear. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they was troubled. They was already in disturbing. When you in disturbing, you have delusion.
There you go. Amen.
Amen.
That is so true.
You're delusion. You think folks against you when ain't nobody thinking about you.
Amen.
You think folks ain't speaking to you when you ain't speaking to them.
Amen.
Come on. Yeah. Oh, this Amen. Thing is tight, but it's good.
Amen.
You become trouble. So when you become trouble, you think the very one that love you, you think they hate you. That's why homes stay trouble all the time.
Amen.
Because if the enemy can tap a family, he tears up the church.
Amen.
Because the church is what? Family. Hell, that's why Jesus said, mother against daughter, father against son. So it keeps the house what in a delusion. So they become trouble. First thing they say, it is a spirit. So we start looking at something, it ain't that. So it's a delusion. Become a delusion. Because we so dysfunction. Oh my God. They say and it's because of what? They cried out for
fear.
So fear is, we got the wrong type of fear. We both fear God, but we fear everything except God. I fear that he gonna leave me. I never get to call this person's name. We were sitting in the class. We were dying around that discussing. And all of a sudden, this person like, I'm looking around wondering what's going on here. This person got the hollering so because of what?
Fear.
She didn't realize he needed her more than she needed.
Yeah, man.
Amen. Come on, y'all.
That's good.
If you don't like it, just go in Lena room.
Amen.
We become dysfunctional. You feel dysfunction, you put that down, feel dysfunction. My God. You get scared, you do stupid stuff. If you know we get filled when somebody calls out, come and get the car, you know you can't make the payment, go on, let them get the car.
Amen.
That's a burden off of you.
All right.
And God will give you another
car.
See how we come? The world calls us to come in dysfunction because of fear. So they became fear.
That's good,
amen.
I hope it helped you. It helped me. And look what he said.
But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer. It is I. Be not afraid.
He telling you what? Jesus trying to tell us, stop being afraid.
Yes.
He hit them today. We stay afraid. Be afraid to speak to folks. Be afraid to even open the door. Let some air get in the house. We afraid. We afraid. Everything we afraid of. I'm afraid. You knocking me, I don't know you. Who are you? What you at my door for? What you want? What you asking me for? We ask 100 questions.
Come on.
They was a... So Jesus tells us, stop being
afraid.
The way he said.
And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou,
by right that night. This way we are. If it be thou, we always looking for somebody to give us a sign. Give me a consummation. I need another. Oh, that was God.
Amen.
Two or three done said that to me. But if he done told you, Peter said, he done told you. Be not afraid. Then here you gotta have somebody tell you again. Don't be afraid. Now who do you believe the most? You see what I'm saying? Peter said, if thou be. He just told you don't be afraid. If God done told you something that he gonna do, why are you so dysfunctional? He's gonna do it. He's a man, he cannot
lie.
If it be thou. That's what Peter said first. So Peter first already done got doubt in his mind. Fear was sent in. He was getting dysfunctional. But look what happened.
Bid me come unto thee on the water.
Now he tell him to bid. Okay, come on.
And he said, come. And Peter was come down out of the ship. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus.
He walked. He was walking. He was looking at who? Jesus. He finally got his focus. He kept his focus on Jesus. We lose our
focus.
And Bucci says, stay focused.
Amen.
We do not stay focused.
But when he saw the wind boisterous,
so when he saw the problem, we lose focus and start looking at the problem. We lose focus when we start looking at the problem and not the problem solved. Jesus was your problem solved. So we lose focus. So we come dysfunction. When he saw, come on,
he was afraid and began to sink. He cried, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him and said unto him, O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt?
So look what Jesus is trying to tell us. Fear take over. He said, be not afraid. The way he said, overlook the faith. Faith. He had enough faith to step out, but he kept, took his faith over the faith song. So Jesus said, overlook him. So his faith had what? Increased enough to trust God in the place that he was put in. We lose our faith when we in the midst of it. We lose it. He said, oh, Lucifer, where did thou doubt? Where did you lose your dysfunction, your function at?
Amen.
See, you got to see where you lost it at.
Amen.
Is it because it didn't come when you thought it was coming? Did you lose it when you, when it got so tough that you thought you couldn't deal with it?
Come on.
See, you gotta see where you are in your faith and where you doubt. Where I lost my function at. Cause see, when I was looking at what was going on here in life abundant ministry,
amen,
I almost lost my focus. Cause I was wondering what was going on. Why this? Why they did this? What was going on? To the point I was about to lose my sleep till God started dealing with me.
Amen.
He let me know it's I that doing this.
Amen.
Come on now. See, something God would do in your life to get you in.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
To get you in focus. To get you in position, to get some things off of you, and get some people out of your way that you thought they were supposed to be in your way.
That's what that was for. Okay.
All right. See, we try to put people in place when they ain't supposed to be there in your way.
Amen.
Come on.
All right.
No.
Okay. Thank you, Lord.
So we get what?
It's a function.
Is that helping y'all? So you need to stay what? Focus in your function. We don't do that.
No.
My God. This is good. He shows it in here, huh? My God. Let me do that.
No, you got 32 and 33.
Okay.
And when they were coming to the ship, the wind ceased. Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, of a truth, thou art the Son of God.
See, when you become to come in a place of dysfunction, you can see what God do. But when you ain't function, you think things against you. But once you see it, you begin to what?
Receive it.
Come on. Receive it. So when they, my God, so they was coming to the end of their dysfunction. So they began to what? Worship him. See, we need to start worshiping him in our dysfunction. And not when we done come out of it. Because sometimes you gotta go right back into it again. Oh, till you learn to,
amen.
Return
to your dysfunction. You be able to function.
Amen. Thank you.
Return. Amen. Amen. I get it.
Amen. Yeah, you get it. So I'm learning how to function. If you don't like me, I will still love you.
Alright, amen.
See? You got to function in the midst of your enemy. You got to stay function. You can't get off. Because I can't function in it. In the midst of it, I got to stay calm and collected in the midst of it.
Yeah.
That you know me so well, you know how to set me off every time you see me.
Yes.
Come on. That's why people do you like you do, because they watch you. You think though they watching you. They watch you, so then when they know you real well, they come in and say, well, I need to get Willie out the way. So I'm gonna do something to move him, so I'm gonna make him mad. He gonna move himself. I ain't got to tell him to move. He gonna get mad with me, and he gonna go.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Because I think about, I talk about Tamika all the time. Tamika said things to her mom and daddy to the point that get them all dysfunctional. Mm-hmm. Get the house all tore. And then she run off.
She did her job.
She did her job. Now they done learned what she doing. So now she being disturbed.
Amen.
Amen. Your email come
dysfunctional.
All right. Because they can understand I used to make her mad. Mm-hmm. Why she being so nice to me?
Amen.
That's why he said I make your enemy your footstool. They can't be your footstool because they better dysfunctional than you.
Amen.
You can't function in the midst of. My God, this is good, y'all.
Yeah.
I hope it helps.
Yes, ma'am.
I hope to survive this.
Yes, thank you.
So, they died calm. Let's go to Mark 6. This is another passage Jesus used. I had three. Mark 6, 45 to 51. My God. See, if I know this years ago, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be where I'm at now. So, this foster.
Yeah.
Everybody wouldn't know me that well.
That's right.
They wouldn't know me well enough to do what they did to me.
Come on.
Come on. Okay, 45 down to 51. All right, look with now. This is another one.
And straight away, he constrained his disciples to get into the ship. And to go to the other side before unto Bethsaida, while he sent the people away.
Mm-hmm.
And when he had sent them away, he departed into a mountain to pray.
Mm-hmm.
And when eve was come, the ship was in the midst of the sea, and he alone on the land.
Okay.
And he saw them toiling and rowing.
So Jesus was seeing you in your what?
Toil.
He see you in your
dysfunction.
I want y'all to see me. He see you in your dysfunction and your can't function. Because he put you in a place where you can't function. So he see your dysfunction. Do you see it? That's what he's trying to say. I want you to see your dysfunction. So the ship represents function.
Yeah.
You got the function in the midst.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. It don't make it sense.
Yeah.
If I make it sense, where the hell? Throw your head until you understand.
Thank you.
So he see you. So if he see you in it, don't he know how to measure to get you out of?
Yes.
If it's here, my God, I hear you. I see it, Holy Ghost. You think about measure cup. Think about measure cup. Okay. He know how much to put in your measure cup to get you out of under that dysfunction. You might not need but a half. Some people might need a third. Some people might need a cup. Some people might have to have two cups.
Yeah.
It depends how long you stay in your dysfunction.
Yes.
They call it depressed.
Thank you.
I'm depressed. I'm in power. But you, he sees you in dysfunction. He saw them So he see you in your. So know how large you can see it. Lord, you just don't know. Yeah, see, right there, he said, he said, oh my God, what happened
to? For the wind was contrary unto them, and about the fourth watch of the night, he cometh unto them, walking upon the sea, and would have passed by
him. Would have passed by him. So that lets you know, my God. He still let him stay in what? He saw, he didn't come to what? The fourth hour he seen. So he would have passed by him. They got themselves on one call, one mind, one spirit, and called on the right name. Some of us, we had dysfunction. And we call it on the wrong name. He would have. So he passed it by. Waiting on us to call the right name. He passed it. I was looking at it. When you gonna, I'm running back, Michelle. When you gonna call? Who you gonna call for the right?
Amen.
Mama Barbara!
Jesus.
Mama!
Jesus.
Joe Bob, will you come? Joe!
Jesus. Amen.
You still it. It ain't seem like it ain't coming out of it. I've been calling everybody.
Amen.
I need $500. Did he?
Jesus.
Did he?
Jesus.
Did he? Somebody call Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
All right, I'm here.
Amen.
Glory,
hallelujah.
My God. Woo. Lord, I came on this
function. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Jesus.
That's good, ain't it?
Yes.
See, he would have passed by. Come on.
But when they saw him walking upon the sea, they supposed it had been a spirit and crying out. For they all saw him. And were troubled.
Now they all saw him, but they were still what?
Troubled.
Jesus could be in the midst of working your stuff out, and you still don't.
Amen.
See. Don't see. But at the end, when you
get out
of it, I see him then. But he's in the midst of your stuff when you said Jesus. But some things he ain't gonna just wipe out right quick, cause he wants you to see where you dysfunction at.
Amen.
So you won't find yourself being in that same position over and over and over again.
Thank you,
Jesus.
For they all saw him and were troubled. And immediately he talked with them and said unto them, be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid.
And see, sometimes Jesus has to immediately move on your behalf.
Yes.
Immediately. He immediately moved on me. Once you begin to what? Calm down. And begin to say, Lord, I thank you.
Yes.
For my trials and tribulations. Lord, I thank you for the
enemy. Yes, Lord.
So
yes.
You done calm down, so then he'll come immediately.
Yes.
And begin to get you out of your dysfunction. So he's teaching you how to function in the midst of out of the dysfunction. That's good. And what happened then?
And he went up unto them into the ship, and the wind ceased,
And they were so amazed in themselves beyond measure. And
they was amazed among themselves. Sometimes we are amazed. How I got out of it. I know it wasn't me. It wasn't who I called got me out of it. It was Jesus. They was amazed in themselves. See, then I told you you had to see who? Yourself.
Yes.
And main thing, see what the main amazing is, how much measure faith you have. See, I can talk faith, but can I walk it? Come on, man.
Amen.
I hear a lot of people talk faith, but they can't what?
Walk
it. So God knows you by your measure of your faith. And you be around people with things going well and everything, blooming.
Yeah.
You got everybody following you. But let something change.
You look at your right.
And no question. Jesus said, are you going to leave me too?
Yeah. Ain't nobody around.
So I wonder, where was your
faith? You was the problem.
See? So it's teaching me where to measure
faith.
Of faith. My God.
Okay.
Amen. That happy?
Amen.
See how God is showing up?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
That was
51. Okay,
you want me to go and get
52? Yeah, 52. I see something.
Okay, 52.
Mm-hmm.
For they considered not the miracle of the loaves, for their heart was hard.
See? Look. But they consider not the miracle. They lost the consideration of what God had did for them before. And then they come right back to their dysfunction. We didn't forget.
Mm-hmm.
God can answer your prayer for something you yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And something hit you today.
Yes.
Yes.
You become
dysfunction.
You done forgot. Get that quick. What God did for you.
Come on.
They consider not the middle of the boat, but their heart were what?
Hard.
So my heart ain't toward God. And it ain't the world either.
No.
Church folks don't have their heart toward God.
Amen.
It's just a routine, a tradition that I went to church.
Amen.
But their heart is not toward God. If your heart ain't told God, so you gonna become dysfunction. Cause he know what came you through. Come to your measure, your faith. So I need to check my heart, my faith. Where my heart at? I ain't got enough money in my pocket. I'm gonna keep it.
Thanks.
Just call Joe Bob won't come by the house every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
He don't come 2 years. I don't see Joe. Is I'm gonna still lose faith?
Amen.
Come on now, the people lose faith.
Yeah.
Children go acting crazy, are you gonna still keep your faith? Come on, man. We get this far. Many things keep us from staying focused because we too caught up in the fear of the
world.
So I need to learn to not look at the world system, but look at the word system.
Yes.
I'm going to survive in the word. Because Jesus ain't going to pass me. The world pass you. It's amazing. You go down there for heaven, you make one penny more than what they had written down, you can't get that. Can't get nothing. So what do the world do? Pass you by. So I need to put my trust in God and not in. You see a whole lot of folks sitting down in place for certain things. But you don't know if they're down on their knees. You got that? Let's turn to John 6, verse 15 through 15 through 21. See the different measures of what Jesus kept his disciples through the word to see how dysfunctional they were. Jesus said, I can walk on anything. Your problem ain't nothing to me. I can walk over that. I can handle that. That's just light to me. Come on, y'all. And we that light is about to kill us. I'm about to go on. My God. I know a lady called me last night. Woman called me and asked for a word. And I told her what the Lord said. Then she called back the friend. The friend called me. And she didn't want to hear what the friend was saying about her boyfriend. And here she said, I'm ready to lay down and die. You are ready to die.
All right.
Because you won't believe what? The truth. People are laying down dying because they won't believe the truth, and they won't believe. Because when you give up what you did, you die. Dead walking around. I look at a lot of dead folks and they're walking around dead. And they think they're in the grave, in the funeral home. No, they walk around dead. No life. Dysfunction. No life. So you dysfunction. You look at your mama, you grow out of your mama, and ain't your mama, it's you that dysfunction.
All right now.
We are dysfunctional people, but we blame others for our dysfunction. My God, I'm tired of being dysfunctional.
Amen.
I really am. Oh, Lord, believe. Yes, ma'am. Not God. Now look at verse 15 of John 6.
When Jesus perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again into a mountain himself alone.
Mm-hmm. Jesus perceived that they want to take him as a what? As a king. He is a king. He didn't want to be a king unto the world. See, that's what people. A lot of that movie stuff that they got on TV. What his name? He dysfunctional.
Amen.
The man is sick, possessed. He's dysfunctional. And what he doing, he taking it out on everybody else. But this man needs help. But he got to see himself. He had preceded that. Jesus said, you ain't gonna make me a king down here. The man. Stop. They want him to make a king of the world. And when he already owned the world. Now why you gonna be king on something you already own?
Amen.
It's already him, so why you gonna make him? You can't make him a king over something he already king over. He's the king of kings.
Yeah.
The Lord of Lords.
Yeah.
He's Lord over you. He let you use his own stuff.
Yeah.
Why are you dysfunctional over his? Yeah. They're trying to make him a natural man when he is a king. The king of kings. A supernatural God. They didn't see him as the problem solved. They didn't see him like that. They saw him as a king, as a normal man. And this is where we are in the church. We still see Jesus in the manger. We still see him as a baby. Crumb and Tie, you see more Crumb and Carol.
Yeah.
He was laying up there in the mansion.
Yeah.
And he done left the mansion 2,000 years ago. And he done, he's no more ahead of us to the place that
I ain't there no more.
I done outgrown that. I'm more mature than that.
Amen.
I'm more power than that. I'm more power than sin some on your table to eat. He said, I know you need these things. I'll do that. Now try me in something else.
Give me something to do.
He stay on the planet. Cause we stay what? Dysfunctional. He perceived that you see him as a little king. Not the king of kings. How much he done matured in your life that you can stay functional? Now that's good.
Yes, it is.
How much he done matured in your life that you can stay functional? Can you stay functional in this level? Or can you lie? He know how much measure of pressure of the sea he can put on you. See, Mo, you go
just about
up.
That, just about that. Mm-hmm.
Read that.
Yeah.
Read that. You read that. See? So you read level right here. He's in the what? Psalm 121. I will lift my eyes to the hill from which, because on my arm needs to be.
Yeah, okay.
So I keep looking.
Yeah,
So I won't stay dysfunctional.
Yeah.
If I keep looking at you like this, I'm going to stay dysfunctional. Has you ever been around folks? Dysfunctional. And then when you come around them and you stay around them about 2 hours, you find yourself you get drained. Yeah. You start acting like God, why I feel like that? I felt good when I got up this morning.
Come on. Speak. Now speak the truth there.
Then I realized I wasn't like this till I got around deep. Got to listen to her dysfunction and self-complain. So here I am.
Dysfunction.
Yeah, good. They here messing with us on the job. My job doing fine. Here I am.
Amen.
Yeah.
It's
not making sense. So we can be happy.
Yeah.
God, if you happy, stay happy.
Amen.
Don't let me go.
Good, what you have about?
I don't see
nothing.
I'm sorry. What you say? You say you have a what? I don't see it. You mean you happy where you at?
Amen.
And you go to smile. What you smiling for? After a while you go looking at me like this. I just took your smile.
All right.
Yeah. Wonder, why are you acting like that? Then you go, after I done walked out, you go like. right. You see what I'm saying? People with a spirit of dysfunction will get you down.
Every time.
So you need to find out. Don't just run up to folks. Say good morning. Listen how they say good morning to you.
Uh-huh.
If they say, come on. Come on. She ain't hearing it today. Then we get away from her.
Amen.
Come on. I'm a Lord. I ain't got to talk about that. But I hear.
But day before yesterday, I can't think what they were doing.
I'm over to a dysfunction house working. It was Wednesday. Because we had Bible study Tuesday.
It was Wednesday.
They was cutting up over there that day.
Amen.
So I done sat up in there, and I come, and so many people come in and out that house. So I'm guarding the grand, the daddy there. So when I came through, the son was coming downstairs. And I said, oh, that's you. And I said, because I didn't know who was coming in and out. And so his little friend was upstairs and got smart with me. And when he got smart, I kind of turned my ass. Who you talking to? Just like that. I can knock this out. I got dysfunction. I turned my head. Who you talking to? Just like that. And when he said, he said, I'm talking to you, he walked off. And I looked at the son, I said, you better tell him.
Amen.
Because he don't know who he messed with, I'll beat his eyes. Dysfunction. I don't tell him about that. I got dysfunction.
Yeah.
I was ready to tear that man head up. And then we...
Thank you, Lord.
I walked around and I called the ex-wife. I said, you better talk to me. The man apologized to me. I found myself being dysfunctional. I saw that. I had allowed myself to get caught up in their dysfunction, and I began to feel the way they feel. If they want to try something, I try with
you. Amen. Amen.
See what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
So I found out, those, I got to change my attitude.
Amen.
Come on. I hope I'm helping somebody.
Yes, ma'am.
Lord, made me tell on myself.
Amen.
I hate that idea to be y'all's pastor.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
I don't need no more than the rest of
you. I'm here, but y'all better not know. Don't let me to tell y'all they got it all together. They don't. Dysfunction too.
That's right.
Amen. All right.
Verse 16.
And when Eve was now come, his disciples went down unto the sea. Now the disciples went. When the evening came, they went on down. They knew the routine. They knew what they had to do. Now we saw the first two times, he told them to go there. Right there, when the evening came, they just went on down then. See, they went. See, we just go. We know the routine of what we're supposed to do. We just
follow along.
Sunday morning, I know I'm supposed to go to church at 11 o'clock. I just come on to church. Okay, look what happened.
And entered into a ship and went over the sea toward Capernaum.
Uh-huh.
And it was now dark, and Jesus was not come to them. And the sea arose by reason of a great wind and blew.
Okay. Read that first part of that verse. And the sea what?
And the sea arose.
Stop right there. The sea arose. Sometimes something just arose up. Hey, for no reason. Hey, you up here around somebody, you talk to them, all of a sudden they come up into an argument.
Yeah.
For no
reason.
So I got to learn not to get dysfunction when something just come up for no reason. We do that. Come out to be an argument for no reason. So we need to watch that too. Why did I start an argument for no reason?
thought about yesterday when we were sitting around eating. I said, I wish I had one of them cherry cheesecake. That's what it was. Over there, everybody looked like on the table had one of those. See, I could have became a what? An uproar. Because some of them had more than what they should have got. For no reason.
But I did.
Amen.
Come on. See, sometimes we need to watch that. You don't have to argue with somebody for no reason. Some people get an argument with you just to get out your way.
Yes, ma'am.
My God. It's coming. Some, and this married couple here, and I don't know if you do that. Some men and women get an argument up with their husband and wife to get out the house because they had other plans.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
Come on.
Man.
Husband and wife, boyfriends. Knowing that I can get up to get out you out there. Right. So if I get you dysfunctional, you are going by my being. For no reason. Okay? Come on.
By reason of a great wind that blew. So when they had rode about 5 and 20 or 30 furlongs, they see Jesus walking on the sea. And drawing nigh into the ship, and they were afraid. But he
hold, I got some. God gave me some. I want you to read that again.
So when they had rowed about 5 and 30 furlongs.
Okay, stop right there. I want you to go to the book. I just saw some more than that. Why do we let stuff get all out of hand before we start giving it to God? Mm-hmm. They got four heads to go out. Instead of telling God. But in the midst of that, he said everything put me in it. So we don't put him in it before we start handling it. We don't put him in before we start handling it, like you said. So we let it go too long. Especially in the body. Some people can know something going on in the church but not tell the pastor. Until they done what? Got all out of pain. They let it go too far. See? And now I'm going to put that to church. Even in our life, at home, or whatever, we let it go too far before we even talk to God about it. Because God said, I know the heart of what? Man. So we let it go too far to the point that we guess what? Dysfunction.
Thank you, Jesus.
Then you are, I'm tired.
Thank you, Jesus.
This wearing me out. Because I let it went too far. And then when it go too far, then I'm taking it out on everybody around me.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
All right, come on, dear.
They see Jesus walking on the sea and drawing nigh into the ship. And they were afraid.
They was afraid. We afraid to let Jesus have.
But he saith unto them, it is I. Be not afraid. Then they willingly received him into the ship. And immediately the ship was at the land.
Okay, now you let stuff go so long, but when Jesus finally stepped in, you had to come into play that you need to be what? Broken. To let go of something.
and then you will to let him have it. But it's all done told you up. You done got you off this fit, this function, and a place that you take your joy, take your peace, take you in a place that you look at folks, other folks, different. And God be done send somebody there to help you, but you so looking at them.
Can't get no help.
Can't get no help because you done got this function. A lot of people can't, my God, and why I'm going this way. Relationship. First relationship get throw you all out of whack. Dysfunction. Then here come a good one. You can't see the good one for the
dysfunction of the
dysfunction. You still looking at the laughter on this man's face, and that ain't the man. So we stay what? Dysfunction. And he trying to get us out of our so we can really see what God really has in store for you. It's so many dysfunctional people. Y'all just be surprised when I hear it. That's why God gave me dysfunction. It's a lot of people. Dysfunction.